good morning and welcome. Our prelude is called Open the Eyes of My Heart, and you're invited to sing along. Also, out of consideration for your brothers and sisters, and out of respect for the real presence of our Lord in the Eucharist, please remember the silence at all times of us.
Entrance hymn this morning can be found in your guide book, number 622, Love Divine, All Loves Excelling.
but I'm your priest today. Yay! Hey, if you got some space around you, that someone that's sick, if you kind of raise your hand, you got some space around you. And if you do, can just kind of squeeze together a little bit so we can get everyone a spot to see if they want to. If you have a spot, just raise your hand next to you. And then if you have a space, just kind of squeeze together just a little bit. Who's got space next to them? Who doesn't want anyone sitting next to them? You got space? There's a few seats up here. I just want to find some spots for people to sit. I mean, you can sit on the floor, too, if you want. That's fine. Yes, there's space up here. Anybody in the back? There's some space in the seat. Sit. Are there sitting there? No. How about here? No. Hey, there's two whole rows that are empty right here in the front. You don't have to, but there's two whole rows right here. I'm only going to preach for about an hour and a half today, so you might want to sit. You're awesome. You're awesome. There's more spaces up front, guys, if you want to sit. Anybody else have a spot next to them before we start? We've got to get the hands raised or just spot to sit. We're family this morning, amen?
Amen.
Amen. Anybody else have a spot to sit? Who's got a spot to sit next to him? Raise your hand. One more time, please. One more time. If you see a hand up, you can sit right there, okay?
Thank you.
Nebraska. Good yesterday and here for weekend masses and for your parish mission, which is starting this Monday night, Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday night at 7 p.m. And so that's why I'm here. And I actually did not fly from Omaha, Nebraska all on my own. I had a couple of bodyguards. And being that there's so many of you, I'm going to ask these two sisters that came with me to come up front so you can see them real quick, if that's okay. So Sister Maria Rita and Sister Catherine Marie are two sisters that belong to a community called the Brides of the Victorious Lamb. And they flew out with me. You don't have to bow to them, it's okay. They came out with me. They're my bodyguards. And everybody we met, I made sure that they knew that these were dangerous people. Danger. If you want some Jesus Kung Fu laid on you, then you want to mess with them. So anyway, if you guys could make them feel welcome, I just want you to give them a big... It's somewhere in here. Lord God, we thank you for the gift of this day. We ask that you pour out your Spirit upon us. Open our hearts to you this morning. And we ask you this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
The children may come forward for children's liturgy and work. Set them on fire, leaving them neither root nor branch, says the Lord of hosts. But for you who fear my name, there will arise the Sun of Justice with its healing rays. The word of the Lord. Jesus Christ. Christ, to work quietly and to eat their own food. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I want to really grow my relationship with God. I gotta be willing to
be uncomfortable. You know what,
amen?
If I want to experience anything new in life, I got to get a little uncomfortable. You know, the weather's changing now, and you know, if it gets cold in the morning, anybody experiences this? It's cold outside and you wake up, and you know, if you take off those blankets, you're going to get a little bit chilly, right? And so the temptation is just to keep snuggled in those blankets, amen? You know, but if I just stay snuggled in those blankets all night, just nice and safe and warm, and I don't get out of bed and do something, what happens for the rest of the day?
Nothing!
Amen? And so it's the same thing in my relationship with God. I want to grow in my relationship with God. I got to be willing to be a little bit uncomfortable. And that's where I experience God's heart. And that's where I allow God to experience mine. Amen? And so I'm going to invite you to turn to those around you, to your left and to your right. And I want you to look into their eyes. And I want you to say this to them. You are a gift. Coming in, young people with tattoos and piercings. I'm like, man, you are, I didn't say this to them, but in my heart, I'm like, man, you are so welcome here. If you feel different in odd times and churchy places, you are so welcome here. Like, that's God's heart, huh? He wants all of his kids to come to know him. Not just those who look prim and proper. I'm sorry I'm spitting on you right now. God doesn't want people who just look all prim and proper. He wants all his kids to know his love. Whether you look like I think you should look or not.
Amen.
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 I don't want to live according to the opinions of people in this world. I want to live according to the opinion of God's heart. And whatever God says is true, and his truth is eternal, and that's what I want my life to be based upon.
Amen.
We have to encourage one another to fall in love with God. We have to encourage each other to get close to Jesus. Because Satan, demonic voices and forces are on the rampage to try to pull me away from God's heart. Offer me all kinds of false loves.
Oh, it looks good. It feels good in the moment.
But it's not real love. And so the Holy Spirit comes into my life, and he's like this. He's like, look, just take my hand. I won't hurt you, I promise. The Holy Spirit, hey, awesome. Okay, so the Holy Spirit comes into my life, and he's like, look, he pulls me. Pulls me. Come on, kind of resist me a little bit. Okay, don't resist that one. He pulls me to God's heart. He's like, look, I know that, you know, something over here there is pulling on your heart, and I know you really want to experience love, don't you? Hey, check out my eyes for a second. I know you really want to experience acceptance. I know you really want to know you belong. I know you really want to know there's a place where you always have, where someone's going to hold you and help you where you're hurting and you're struggling. I know you want someone to be in your life that's always going to encourage you and say you're an awesome gift. And I want you to live the gift that you are. You see, I know it's inside of you because it's inside of me too. And God put that in our hearts. And all these other weird people that are looking at us right now, God put it in their hearts too. But there's only one source of love in this world, and it's God's heart. There's lots of fake loves, but there's only one true source. And so I want to be your friend. And I want you to be my friend. And I want us to encourage each other to get close to the real love. Amen? Let's give it up for, what's your name? Krista? Krista, let's give it up for Miss Krista. My truest friend is the one who encourages me deeper into God's heart. And we have to be that for one another. Amen? I need you to do that for me. And you need me to do that for you. Amen? So I want to share a quick story about some encouragement. When I was in high school back in Smyrna, Tennessee, just a few minutes outside of Nashville, I'm part of a parish there. You know, Tennessee is only 3% Catholic, the whole state. Very few Catholics in Tennessee. And so we have a small parish. And there's this youth retreat coming up in Steubenville, Ohio. And my mom, she's like, I want you and your younger sister to go on that retreat. We're like, no way. And so we didn't want to go. And my mom wanted us to go. So guess what we did? Oh, we went. And so mom grabbed us and my sister. She threw us in the bus. We cruised out to Steubenville, Ohio. We get there, we get out of the bus, and I look around and I see a couple thousand teenagers just like me. Most of them were probably thrown in the bus too. And so the weekend goes on, and there's different talks and sharings, and there's some music and stuff, and we're talking about Jesus this and Jesus that, and I'm like, man, I've heard all this in my church before. I don't believe in Jesus. I don't think he's real. God, I don't even think God wants to help me. I don't think God's with me. And so, you know, we live out of what we believe, not what we think. We live out of what we believe, not what we throw our heads with. I can have a whole catechism and not know God. Woo! Did you hear me? And
so the weekend's going along, and Saturday night, one of the priests brings Jesus out, blessed sacrament, real, truly God, truly man, places Jesus in what's called a monstrance, and we have a time of adoration. And so there's a simple invitation during that time. Look, just open your hearts to God, because He wants to love on you. And so me and about 2,000 other teenagers are focused on Jesus. And we're trying our best to sing the songs to kind of enter in. And when we did that, the Holy Spirit of God rested upon us. And I saw different things that I had never seen before. Over here, I saw a young man, and this guy had his hands up in the air, and he was praising God as loud as he could. I was like, whoa. Ain't never seen nothing like that before. Over here, I saw a young lady, and she was kneeling on the ground, and she was just crying. The tears were just pouring out of her, like God was touching her heart. I'm like, whoa. She's praying. God's loving on her. I had never seen that before. I look over here, there's another guy, and he's praying in tongues, like at Pentecost. I'm like, whoa. I ain't never seen nothing like that before. I look over here, there's another young lady, she's just at peace. She's just completely at peace, just resting in God's presence. I look over here, another young man, he's giggling and laughing, like joy is coming out of him. Like, you know, sometimes life steals our joy. Amen, somebody?
Amen.
And God was restoring the joy that had been stolen out of his life. He was just giggling and laughing, like, God, it's so good. And so I'm looking at all these different things, and two words came to my heart, to my mind. And this was those two words. Weirdo alert.
Crying like a little bitty baby, man.
It was awesome. You had one of those gut cries, like uncontrollable gut cries. The tears are flowing, the snot's hanging right there. You can't control it. It's just coming out. Anybody ever experience that? Okay, five people. Okay. It hurts. You see, it hit the pain in my heart that was crying out something like this. You know, we got to hear our heart's voices here. So my heart was crying, I sure wish somebody would understand the hurt that I'm in. I sure wish my dad would spend time with me. I sure wish my mom would hold me. I sure wish someone would listen to what's going on in my life. I sure wish I didn't have to feel all alone. I sure wish I knew there was some hope and some help and somebody I could turn to no matter what's going on. Jesus met me in my pain. And that's where He loves us the most. Amen. And so that stuff was just coming out crying like a baby. By the way, real men cry.
Amen.
Jesus is the ultimate man. And if you're better than Jesus, then you don't have to cry, but Jesus cried. Man, we got to live from our hearts, not just up here. Our families, our friends, and those around us, it needs to be men of the heart who really feel and understand. Amen?
Amen.
I thought it was still going to happen. And so, this experience of God put me on a journey. Those people around me, some of those teens that came with me, I'm sitting there crying like a baby. The snot's moving all over the place. They're looking at me, and you know what they were probably thinking? Weirdo alert. In that moment, I did not care what anybody thought about me. I don't give a rip what people are thinking about me. I am experiencing what I was created to know, and that's the love of my Father God. I went back home and people said, well, I wouldn't have opened my heart to God. I wouldn't have embarrassed myself like that. Cried before other people, and my response to them was this. I'm glad you went back to this church. You see, because we have to anchor each other in that part. Amen? I cannot experience God's love without the Holy Spirit. I cannot share God with you without the Holy Spirit. Amen? So I like to close out the psalm with a little prayer to the Holy Spirit. And so let's just close our eyes for a second. Like, you don't have to say this prayer, but in your seat where you're sitting right now, within your heart, you're like, yeah, God, I want to know more of you. I want to know that you're real in my life. I want to know, Lord, that even if everything around me is falling apart, you are the one person that will never leave me. I want to know your healing. I want to know your hope. With our eyes closed, I'm not going to ask you to stand or anything like that, okay? But with our eyes closed, I just want us to move in faith. If that's you, I just want you to just raise your hand. Nobody's looking because our eyes are closed. But if that's you, I want you to raise your hand. That's me, God. Okay, now I can bring my hand back down. And so here's a simple prayer, which you'd like to repeat it. Holy Spirit, thank you for loving me. Thank you for never leaving me. Thank you for believing in me. Thank you for accepting me. Just as I am. And I ask you, to hold me now, to heal me, to be my peace, to be my love, to be my hope, to be my courage, to be my all in all. And with our eyes closed, I'm just going to invite you to picture just a picture of Jesus or Mary. And I want you to just picture them holding your hand. Or maybe they're hugging you. Or maybe they're just near you because they want to be. And in your own heart,
maybe just share where you need their help the most today. Just in your own heart, just share that. Don't be ashamed. Don't be afraid. And now in that scene, just looking like Jesus or Mary, we're going to ask them a simple question. How do you want to help me today? Jesus, Mary, how do you want to help me today? And just picture that scene and just see what you feel they're speaking to your heart right now. Let them encourage you. More of you in our day-to-day lives. Help us to encourage each other into your heart. And we just pray this with gratitude in Jesus' name. Amen. And amen. And amen.
Amen.
And amen.
Amen.
A little PS of that story after that Steubenville youth conference, that was when I first started thinking about becoming a priest. So if God can take a little hillbilly kid like me and do something cool in my life, He can do something cool in anybody's life. Amen?
Amen.
Whether you got this cool beard or not, we want to give God permission to move in our lives. Amen?
Amen.
Let us stand and we profess our faith. I believe one God,
Father Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial of the Father. Through Him all things were made.
Mass is being offered, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Jesus, help us to fall more in love with you. Thank you for hearing and answering all these prayers through Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Again, for the preparation of the gifts, can be found in your gathering book, number 603. How can I keep from singing?
Honor it with loving devotion through Christ, our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We give the promise of the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, and really enough salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, for whom we raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the paschal mystery. And so, Father, the angels, we praise you as in joyful celebration. We become Christ.
Died in your mercy, welcome you into the light of your face.
have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, and all the saints, who have pleased you throughout the ages, we merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, the praise and glory by you, your Son, Jesus Christ. For through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor, glory, forever and ever.
Communion Psalm can be found in your Gather Book, number 659. Blessed are they.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jesus, for your peace. Thank you, Jesus, for your peace. Thank you, Jesus, for your country. Thank you, Jesus, for you. And let us pray.
Grant us, we pray, O Lord our God, the constant gladness of being devoted to you, for this full and lasting happiness to serve with constancy the author of all that is good. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
This afternoon at 5:30, there will be a potluck dinner in the parish center to welcome Father and Sister Marie and Sister Rita. Tomorrow night, even though it begins at 7, there will be praise and worship starts at 6:30 before the conference begins. And then Tuesday night, Mass will not start at 7, but rather at 6:30 and the conference at 7.
I want to thank you for allowing me to pray with you this morning in Mass. And for those of you that were sitting there thinking, man, when's that guy going to shut up? Thank you for your patience. I personally want to invite you to Mission starting tomorrow night, Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday. And it starts at 7 p.m. each night, tomorrow night, 6:30. There's praise and worship before time. So,
get your praise on.
Anyway, the mission is which nights? What time does it start?
7.
And tomorrow night, praise and worship starts at?
6:30.
And being as I know you're not all going to probably come back to the mission, I just want to say this. We may not always believe in God, but He always believes in us. And that's something we got to hold on to tight. Amen? Amen. And so before we get to final blessing, I'm going to invite you to turn those to your left and your right, look them in the eyes and say, you look just like Jesus.
Number 678, City of God.